Hello everyone, welcome back. It's been a long couple of weeks, a lot of work. I've been very busy and I've been wanting to do this video review for a while now. The helmet's been ready and I'll tell you why I say it's been ready, but we're doing the Hasbro Black Series First Order Stormtrooper helmet review and comparison. Of course, I'll show you guys another helmet that I have, but I have, ever since the movie came out, okay, I was not into this design whatsoever. I'm an original trilogies kind of guy, so, and again, like I told you guys, I go off how I feel, but this is my thing, okay? I've always loved this design. I love the original Macquarie design. I love the skull look to it, okay? This is amazing. So, when The Force Awakens came out, they introduced this design of a Stormtrooper helmet. I wasn't really into it. I felt that the helmet looked a little bit too much like a motorcycle helmet to me. Not enough like a Stormtrooper helmet. But when Hasbro released it, I said, you know what? Let me give it a try and let me just pick one up. And I gotta say that it's kind of grown on me a little bit. But it does have some issues, but overall it is, again, another very well made, well done helmet replica. Okay, and I'm gonna keep going and expanding on this, but it's growing me a little bit. I like it. I just thought like the helmet wouldn't have any justice unless you actually made the actual the actual bloodlines on the helmet from when Finn's partner dies in combat. So I wanted to do that with the helmet before I did this review. And I gotta say that the helmet's finally done. It's been done for a little bit, but haven't gotten around to making this video. So here's the video. Here's the box. Again, guys, it's a box. You wanna see it? Okay. Again, not your typical square. Nice artwork. Okay. And that's it. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get to the helmet, okay? So here it is. This is the Black Series Hasbro First Order Stormtrooper helmet. Bam, voila, there it is, okay? All painted up, done. Okay, this is the main reason that I bought this helmet. I wanted to go ahead and do this, you know, blood marks or whatever you want to call it. I guess it's a palm print from Finn's partner dying in battle. Okay. And I'm going to show you guys a little bit of the artwork up front. There it is. You guys decide. Side view there, the back, dirt and sand from Tatooine. And there are those gorgeous bloodlines. Okay, so let's start off with a couple of things. As you all know, I paint and I do a lot of the artwork and I build a lot of props myself, but I didn't want to do this for myself. I wanted my brother to do it, okay? My brother is a professional airbrush artist and he's got a talent for this kind of stuff, okay? So I just wanted him to do it, all right? I just wanted him to put his twist on it or his artwork to this. Okay, I didn't want to do it myself, so I told him to do it and it came out amazing. Okay, he's a professional airbrush artist. He does a lot of work down here in South Florida. Okay, he paints a lot of pro football players and race cars and stuff like that. So if you want to give him a look, he's on Instagram as Color Goat. That's KOLORGOAT. Color Goat. So if you want to check out some of his work, okay, go ahead and check out his page. But he did this helmet, he did the paint work, came out phenomenal. Okay. All right, let's talk about the helmet itself. The helmet is, as expected, okay, Black Series has been doing some really great work lately, and it is really, really well made, okay? Again, it is injection molded plastic. It is extremely sturdy, all right? This helmet is got, it has some weight to it, all right? It is extremely sturdy. It is very strong, okay? And it feels like it's got some thickness to it as well, okay? So as you go from the outer layer into the inner layer, you can see that my hand is right here, and it is, it's got some thickness to it, okay? Unlike some vacuum formed helmets, all right? And I'll show you what I mean by that. Okay, some vacuum formed helmets, they're just very, very thin, okay? So this is it, this is all I get from a vacuum formed helmet sometimes, okay? Very thin, very light, okay? Very flimsy, all right? But this thing definitely has some weight and heft to it, all right? Very well made. So the eyes, okay, are bubble lenses. I don't know if you guys can see that, okay? They are slight bubble lenses there, staying true to the design, okay? And overall, the helmet size is a good size, okay? Now, you know that these are all, I don't know what that is. You know that these are all electronic helmets. So this does have an electronic feature to it. It is just this. It's a voice changer, and I am not into voice changers, but it's a voice changer. There you go. So when you press it a second time, you got the voice changer feature, FM2187. 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 So again, not very good. Not a very good voice changer. Okay, you turn it on to turn on the voice changer feature and tap it again to turn it off. Okay. Not a very good feature, but that's what it comes with. Okay. Let's see what else we can talk about this. The biggest difference or the biggest complaint that I have is this here. Okay. For some reason, they put teeth, okay, like Stormtrooper traditional. Original trilogy Stormtrooper teeth on this design, okay? It's, this helmet is not supposed to have that. This helmet is supposed to have the honeycomb pattern, okay, going all around the entire frown area, okay? It's supposed to be a honeycomb pattern. Why Hasbro decided to do that, I'm not sure. Maybe for safety reasons, breathability. I'm not exactly sure why I did that, okay? But that is a the major difference, okay? The major difference. So if you can deal with that, this is a amazing helmet, all right? The inside, again, Hasbro always makes their helmets very clean on the inside. Nice details, all right? The actual fastener inside is a little different, okay? Most of these helmets, whether it be Hasbro or any type of other helmet, they typically bring that hard hat helmet liner inside. Okay, I'll show you what I mean, because I pulled this out of a Novus helmet. So it's typically this, all right? Typical hard hat helmet liner, and you just kind of like, you know, turn this to tighten it and loosen it. And it fits on your head, okay? You adjust it to size, all right? This doesn't have that. This has more of a, like a one strap going down the center line there. And then at the back, it's got like a, an elastic strap that goes around the back of your head, okay? So it is a little different design, but it's fine, it works. It does what it's supposed to do, all right? Like I told you guys, for the most part, I'm not gonna wear this helmet anywhere. This is just solely for display. But the helmets that I do wear, I do different things for the inside to make sure that they're nice and sturdy on my head. Okay, they don't move around or flop around on my head once they're in there. And these don't tend to be very reliable, okay? All right, That's it. I mean, it's a nice piece. Yeah, I gotta say, it is a very nice helmet. They did a good job with it. Okay, I'll add some pictures of this particular helmet and up close shots and stuff like that of all the paintwork and everything around. Now, let's get to the comparison part of this video. Okay, I have a second helmet. Now, this helmet is not mine, it belongs to a friend. And my brother, Color Goat, on Instagram, he painted this helmet as well. So let's go ahead and grab this one. And here it is. Okay. Now, this helmet belongs to a friend of mine, like I said. It's not mine. I'm supposed to be returning it to him as soon as I finish with this video and this review. Okay. This is the Anovos First Order Stormtrooper helmet. So again, when we're talking about Anovos, they have access to certain actual screen use film props and things of this nature. So they are probably going to be the closest to screen accurate that you can find out there. Okay. So with that said, I want you guys to check out the helmets. So I'm going to put them as close together and aligned as possible. And there they are. And you can see that they are pretty spot on as far as the size. Okay. They are pretty spot on. If anything, from the front, they look pretty almost the same, okay? But I would have to say that this helmet still is about a half an inch taller than the Anovos helmet, okay? And it is very noticeable when you turn the helmets sideways, okay? So when I turn the helmet sideways, you're gonna see that it's very noticeable that the Hasbro helmet is slightly taller. Again, not by a whole lot, but it's just about half an inch taller than this one is, okay? By no means anything that's gonna be significant. Okay, here's the back together. And then you can see that little height difference there. Going to the right side. And back to the front. There it is. Not bad. So, like I was saying before, here it is. Here are the teeth, or this frown area, okay? This area is known as the teeth on the original trilogy Stormtrooper helmets. And this does have those, or the teeth there. Okay, you can see that, okay? It does have honeycomb pattern on this side. That honeycomb pattern should have ran all the way across to the other side. Okay, for some reason, they didn't do that, okay? Here's what I'm talking about. Here's the Anovos, and here's that honeycomb pattern running all the way across the frown to the other side, okay? There it is. And you can see the same bubble lenses, all right? They both have bubble lenses. The visibility is not bad at all. I would say about 90%, meaning that when I say that, I mean that there's only about a 10% distortion as a result of the curvature in the glass. Okay, so it's not too bad. It's okay. All right. The mic tip here, okay? These are hobby mic tips. All right. They both have them. But I gotta say that Hasbro invested in a metal or aluminum, some kind of metal mic tip, okay? While the Anovos one is plastic, okay? Again, look at that. It is metal, it's nice shiny metal, very strong. Okay, and the Anovos one is a plastic one, all right? And look at the differences in widths or thicknesses, okay? This is here, all right? From the outside wall to the inside wall, we're at about right here, all right? Again, very thick helmet. So basically this line right here is the thickness of the actual helmet in its entirety all the way around, okay? And then again, injection molded, and this is vacuum formed, all right? And you can see that this right here is the thickness of the helmet, okay? Very thin, All right, we're talking about this much. Okay, very thin helmet, very thin wall. All right, very light helmet. All right, but definitely vacuum formed. So, again, Hasbro blew it out of the park. One last thing that I want to say about this, it slipped my mind earlier, but I do want to touch on this. The features or the details on this helmet are much sharper than the actual Anolis helmet. Okay, and what do I mean by that? Well, if you look here, okay, at this area here, all right, this little indentation here is much sharper looking than this indentation area here, okay? So it is hard to make out unless you have both helmets in front of you, okay? Also, this line that goes all the way around this area here, this line is a much deeper recessed line, okay? So very sharp lines on the Hasbro helmet. Okay, and a little bit on the mild side here, all right. Now your vents on the side. I want you guys to note two differences in vents. Okay. On the Hasbro helmet, they are slightly thinner and longer. And on the Anovos helmet, they are a little shorter and wider. Now again, I gotta go with Anovos being the screen accurate ones. Okay, so just know that Hasbro, they did a lot of good things correct, okay? But the only two things that I can see are a little off are gonna be the frown. Okay, the frown area where they have these teeth. I mean, I like the look personally because, like I said, I'm partial to the original trilogy Stormtrooper, but this here would be the correct look, okay? You have to have that honeycomb pattern going all the way across the frown, okay? You can't have the teeth on like on this one. And then you got those vents on the side that are a little different looking, okay? Now the vents are cutouts, okay? Unlike original trilogy Stormtrooper helmets, they were decals or stickers or painted on or what have you, okay? So this here are cutouts, just like this one, they are cutouts, okay? So there it is. Your Hasbro Black Series First Order Stormtrooper Helmet, FN2187 with the blood stripes on it. There's one, and here you have your Anovos helmet. And for size comparison, I've got a Hasbro Black Series Shadow Trooper helmet. Okay, you can see the sizes there between all three. Let's move this out of the way. Yeah, these two front views, good size, and side view. So again, very well made helmet. I'm very happy with it, especially the paint job that my brother did to it. Definitely gonna look great in the collection. And I really appreciate that he did that for me. Okay, he actually did two of them, obviously, but, and I appreciate he did the paint work for me. It took him a little while because he's a busy guy, but once it was all said and done, it turned out beautifully, okay? So I'm very happy with it. This is again, Hasbro Black Series First Order Stormtrooper helmet. I think you guys should go pick one up. If you haven't already, you don't have one in your collection, I think it's worth having in the collection. Okay, I think that they, again, knocked it out of the park. Little minor details here and there, but it's a great helmet, great looking helmet, okay? That's it, guys, all right? Anything you guys wanna discuss or ask me, all right, go ahead and leave it in the comments below, and that's it. I'll be doing another video shortly and as soon as I can. Okay. And you guys let me know what you think about the Hasbro Black Series First Order Stormtrooper helmet. All right, take care. Catch you in the next one. Be easy.